I'm very, very happy to be here. One of the things that I was very interested in when I came into office, because the Honorable Prime Minister, in one of the things that he gave me for me to do, was he made it very clear that I have to look at continuing professional development for our staff. So I was very excited about it, because coming from an academic background, continuing professional development is something that we do very regularly. And I also was really excited because it was coming from the Honorable Prime Minister himself. And I had a discussion with the director, and I said everybody has to have continued professional development, which includes the pharmacists, but also includes your biomedical engineers and biomedical technicians. And he said to me, "Bunwai, really?" I said, "Really." He said, "Why?" "No, because the Honorable Prime Minister made it very clear that continuing professional development of all our staff is very important. And the way that our government works, we leave no one behind. So that means that we can't only have professional development for doctors, but everybody has to be developed." And I'm also delighted to be here because we're looking at how we can further progress biomedical engineering, because I really believe that you play a very, very important role. The other thing that also concerns me, that often, in my opinion, and again I may be wrong, that biomedical technicians and biomedical engineers feel alienated in the hospital and in the Ministry of Health and in the health setting. And they feel like they are just an auxiliary staff or an auxiliary staff. And I want to make it very clear today, with the media and Ministry of Information here today, make it very clear that you are a very important cog in the wheel of the Ministry of Health. And the Ministry of Health works because of your good work. And I speak that not only as a minister, but having been a surgeon for 20 years and being very reliant on very good, competent and capable machinery and equipment to help me in my work. And not only that, but as we speak, there are patients all over Fiji and all over the world that are alive because at the moment, some equipment, some monitor, some life-saving equipment is working on their behalf and supporting them. And I congratulate the director of PBS for coming up with his magnificent idea of today, the ministry, and I welcome all of you from wherever you come from, the North, West, and also CWM, and also welcome our colleagues and our esteemed speakers for today, including the dean from the school, from the College of Business at the FNU. The timing of this workshop is right, considering the demand for improvement in our service delivery. And over the last 10 months that I've been in office, I've made it very clear from the onset that I wanted professionalism, efficiency, and improving the facilities. I'm very happy to say at this juncture that I realized that we've improved a bit. And that feedback has come through because we, you know, our 157 complaints hotline is now beginning to receive not only complaints, but also remarks saying that we're doing a good job. We're also beginning to see members of the public write to us and speak to us and tell us we're doing better. But in my opinion, I am saying that we should actually say nothing has happened and that we could continue to improve. And the timing for improvement will continue to be on a day-by-day basis. We have to say on a regular basis and wake up every morning, today is another day for improvement. And we are undergoing through structural adjustments and processes. As we go forward, we get hit in certain ways, but we must make sure that we develop resilience. A case in point, for example, is the fire that happened at CWM. And as you know, we had the boiler go down, we had the laundry go down, but we took stock. We looked at ways in which we can become better, and then we charted another pathway. The Minister of Health has now gone full steam into this global phenomenon called universal health coverage. Universal health coverage is about taking the service to the people. So there are the three pillars of the universal health coverage. One is reaching the unreached, two is leaving no one behind, and three is decreasing the out-of-pocket expenses for our people, the Fijian people. So that is the reason why we now have specialist clinics in health centers and in the subdivision hospitals. That is the reason why we have a WHO EMT certified organization called FEMAT, which is only the ninth country in the world. That is also the reason why they were operating out of Korobo in a tent hospital last week. But as you realize, the things that I'm saying, taking specialists to health centers and subdivision hospitals, operating out of subdivision hospital, being able to take the MV Vibweti, which is in Kandawu at the moment, and operate on the MV Vibweti, it requires good and capable equipment, good and capable monitoring. And that's why your role is very, very important. We cannot go forward with universal health coverage without the good work of biomedical department, biomedical engineers, and the biomedical technicians. The profession was initially set up in 1989 through the Australian Staffing Assistance Scheme with a staff of 9, and now we have 29 staff. I remember there was an Australian, when I was a medical student, he used to run the service. He had an old, beat up, at that time, in 1994, 1995, his old Toyota White Land Cruiser. I don't know if you remember that. And he used to go all around the country. And if I remember correctly, his name was David. And we used to wonder, well, who is this David, Dr. David, Mr. David? What does Dr. David do? And later I realized that we learned that he was a biomedical engineer from Australia who'd come over to start up this. And back in the days, everyone was ignorant of the usefulness of biomedical engineers and biomedical technicians. From that lonely David, we now have 29 staff. And I'm very proud of how we've developed, more so over the last 10 years. This shows the commitment that you have as a personnel to develop yourselves and be part of the Ministry of Health, but more importantly, the commitment of government in realizing the important role that the biomedical unit plays. Over the years, we continue to have support from Australia, apart from their DFAT support, but also through specialized, strengthening specialized clinical services, or SCIP, and now in its other form, that's now based at the South Pacific Commission, and Mrs. Tao is here on that behalf. And I'm very hopeful that we will continue to grow. You play a very important role in our healthcare system. And now, the inventory of equipment as of 2019 is 7,159 working equipment in the Ministry of Health. That's a lot of equipment for 29 people. Budgetary provisions increase. The spare parts allocation, for example, in 2017, was 500,000. In 2019 budget, only 2 years after, is 1.5 million. In addition, 5.5 million has been allocated this year for the purchasing of equipment. As we continue to grow and new technology comes, and as you also know, with biomedical equipment, it has a lifespan of about 10 or 14 years, and new equipment does arrive, just like standard of care in medicine. The government is keen to audit and remove aging equipment. We had about 48 tons of old equipment and old beds and rubbish taken away from CWM just a few months ago. And now here in Lotokwe, it was about 22 tons, maybe more as of today. And we need to continue to remove the aging equipment. We need to say this has a half-life or so and so, it's going to finish at this particular time, and have a replacement pathway in place. And I'm glad that that's something that the head of APBS has done. Good examples of what we need to do is within the next few years, we will be looking at replacing the MRI scanner at CWM. I'm also pleased to say that we have a doctor trained in China, local doctor, done a master's in radiology, specifically in MRI. She's now returned in Lotoka and coming to Utsuba at the end of this year to start reading the MRI results from the MRI machine. The equipment nowadays are becoming more complex, and technologies are evolving and they continue to evolve. And therefore, it demands a high level of knowledge and skill to provide precise designs, standards, and environmental conditions for proper functioning, at the same time considering the intricate logistics and lowering overall costs. I believe, and I strongly believe, that the ministry, through the unit, can pursue better outcomes to improve our service delivery. I'm told that the biomedical profession now has a very dynamic workforce, and I believe in each and every one of you to raise the bar in terms of service delivery. The future of this profession is in your hands, and you must continue to endure and maintain professionalism and integrity of your profession and your ministry. You must look at yourselves as professionals, not as just an auxiliary staff or an auxiliary staff, but a true professional. And this ministry is based on professionals. It's based on health professionals, it's based on engineering professionals, and it's based on corporate professionals. And you are a professional. And on that note, I wish to acknowledge and thank you for your continuous effort in taking extra steps to ensure that the equipments are repaired and serviced, restored, and for the betterment of providing healthcare services and for saving the lives of all Fijians. Ladies and gentlemen, you have an opportunity to exchange experiences. You have an opportunity to chart the way forward. You have an opportunity with the Dean here today to be able to give him some thoughts on the opportunities for education in biomedical engineering. And I trust that you will believe in the purpose that we have set ourselves in, and that is universal health coverage. This week in New York, on Monday, there was a side event in which the Honorable Prime Minister went and spoke on our behalf on universal health coverage. You see how important that is. Once again, thank you for the invitation. May you all have a pleasant weekend, and I look forward to the outcomes of this meeting. Lovely.
Thank you, sir.